AI is taking over everything, from writing code to automating security tests and so much more. But what if I told you that AI could also help you hunt bugs in web applications? In this video, we will put ChatGPT to the test to see if it can be a real hacker's assistant. Can AI help us to find vulnerabilities faster or better? This is what we will know in this video. This is not about replacing hackers, it's about exploring how tools like ChatGPT can augment our bug hunting process. We will do a basic ethical hacking, compare results, and see what we will get. So, this is AmrSec, go get your coffee ready, and let's dive in. To keep this fair, I will use a vulnerable web application as our target. We all know that this app is a piece of cake for any hacker, but we will divide our bug hunting process into three parts. First is going to be the manual testing. We're going to use a traditional methods to uncover bugs. And after that, we're going to use AI-assisted testing, providing ChatGPT with real requests, responses, data to see if it can suggest meaningful exploits. After that, we're going to compare all of that to see how well AI-assisted testing stacks up against manual testing. Okay, so right here, we're going to use burp if we want a specific request or so. And right here, we have Mr. ChatGPT, where we're going to ask some questions about what we have. But first, we have to let him know what are we doing. Okay, so we're going to tell him, for example, so hey, I'm a security researcher and I have my own app that I'm testing some bugs on, like XSS, Aridor, SQL and others. I need your help to spot if there is a specific bug you can see in anything I will give you. Let's make it in the data I will give you. So right now I'm just telling him that this is my own app. So because if I just told him that this app is not belonging to me, it will just tell me, hey, thank you, but I cannot assist you with finding bugs and so on. But if I told him, like, I'm a bug bounty hunter and this is program, maybe it will help me. But most of the times when I get to sensitive point, it just telling me, sorry, I cannot assist you with exploiting some vulnerabilities and so on. So I'm just telling him that right now. And let me see what we will get. And as you can see right here, it's telling me, okay, just share with me HTTP requests or code snippets or anything. So right here, let's start with manual testing. I will leave ChatGPT like it is right now. And I will go to my Chromium that's proxied to Burp. Let me just open that. And as you can see right here, it's just static website. We all know the bugs within it, but let's start spotting what we can. First, we have here an input. Let me just write anything right here and hit go. And as you can see right here, it's reflecting what we do. Let me see if there is any inputs right here. Okay, we have here guestbook. We can test that too. So right here, let me start testing manually. Right here, we have SVG on load alert. And just when you hit go, as you can see, we have an XSS right here. And okay, let me back, for example, to the guest book, and let's write something like img source equal x, so the source is invalid, and on error I want you just to alert me with this, and close it and copy it and add the message. And as you can see, we got a blob. So right here, this is supposed to be an image, but because it's invalid, we got a bubble. And I think if we just reloaded this, this is stored. Okay, it's not stored. So this what we got. We have right here 2xss. Let me see what we can do again. In our profile, for example, we can just try with something like admin this or 1=1... and any password, nothing happens. Let me try to add the script right here, login, still nothing. Let me go with test and login, and right here is giving me a user info, and this gave me this data. But how it gave me this data, we cannot see any user IDs right here, and in the cookies payloads. Let me intercept this right here. Okay, reload, continue, and okay, forward this, and I want to open this one. Okay, so right here, if we just send this, we're going to get the user data, I think. Okay, let's just search with the data, and we have the personal info, the data of the user, and credit card number. What is that? Okay, we have the credit card. Oh, this is cool, actually. Okay, here we have the name of the user, but what if we just removed the login and just send this? As you can see, it's asking us to log in first. So what if we just add it right here, select all from users and send this, and as you can see, we have a MySQL error right here. And what if we just tried something where ID equal 1. Let me just remove this and try to send it. Nothing. Okay, so what if I try just here to drop the user's table and send? And okay, this needs further investigations. Well, we have right here a SQL injection, we can specify it. And just let me back right here and see what also can we do. Let me just stop the proxy, and in the categories, nothing that good. Let me just try to add something cool right here and other cool thing right here. And we have alert, and thank you for your comment. You're welcome. So right here we have 2 XSS and we have SQL injection. I'm pretty sure what I have to do, just give this app like another 5 minutes and you will just get an RCE. So right here, let me try to give this data to ChatGPT to see what we can get. So like a normal user, I will just take a screenshot of this. And back here to our cool friend ChatGPT, take this screenshot, and let me back here for my cart. Okay, there is nothing, sign up. So let me take a screenshot of this too. And let me just take this part without the test. Let me give it here too. And we have like our guest book. Can just take a screenshot right here too. And let me just sign up right here and try to take a huge screenshot with the URL within it and send it to. And we'll tell them, for example, so right now I have these inputs data. What should I try? And just hit enter and let's see what ChatGPT will do. And as you can see, it's start to giving us some ideas right here. For the guest book, it's told you can just try script and try script in the search bar too, and it's told you to try SQL injection for the username and password, and it's asking us to do this in the search bar too. So why not? It's asking us for the IDOR user ID or item ID. We will get back to this one right now. And for the authentication, and it's only to try to do this. Okay, so let me try this first, because I think this will not happen, but why not? So right here, okay, it's not found. Let me back right here and try what's told me first. In the guest book, we know that this will work. Here it is. Okay, thank you. And in the search bar too. Okay, and it's told us to try or 1=1 in the search bar. This is a little weird, but as you can see, it didn't work. So there is no problem with that. For the IDOR, we're going to come back for it. And for the username and password, it told us to try, okay, logout. Okay, so right here we will try or1=1 and or1=1 and login. As you can see right now, we already logged in. Actually, I didn't expect that. But right here, you can see that you are logged in with this user and their credit card number that have characters. Okay, and you can just do whatever you want and update, and that's it. So let me back again and provide it with some HTTP requests. And right here, I will let them know that I have logged in with this request. So right now I have logged in using test, and this is the request for my profile. And let's see what we will get. And as you can see right here, it's telling you that the cookie includes the request. Try to modify. Okay, try using another user's potential cookie value or inject a random malformed. Okay. And it's telling you this request include refer, modify it or remove it to see if there is anything will happen. And you can just try to get this. And as you can see, it's telling you you can just test for XSS in the user agent and refer. And for the broken access control, it's telling you try admin. Okay, so let me try all of them. First, let's start with manipulating the cookies. For example, we're going to add test. So we're going to change test to any random thing, for example, this. And send this request. And let me search for name. Okay, I need the next one. Okay, and as you can see right here, the username is input and password. There is no value, right? Let me show the response in the browser right here and see what we got. Okay. Okay, so as you can see right here, I think it's realized that we are not logged in, because the cookie that we have right here can just change it like this and save it and go right here for user info and see what we will get. Okay, so right now there's nothing appear here, but in the repeater it's not logged in even. Okay, so this didn't work, but it's told me to try to remove this and send it, and it looks good. Okay, so let me back and see what's asked to. Okay, it's told me to try this, so let me try this right here. Okay, test. I don't think that this app even smart to realize this, but let me only try this one. And I don't know why the page became like that, but it's still the same user, so this didn't work too. So Rahil is trying to see the privilege escalation. This is not possible because the app already designed for CSRF, XSS and SQL injection. But right here, what I just saw, stolen me file not found. That's right. Okay, go to the profile and let me right here change this email to mail, for example, and add it here with this guy and open the proxy, fire it, and let me just update and take a screenshot. And here, do you think there is CSRF? Already we know that there is, but let me see what ChatGPT will tell me. And as you can see, it's telling you that there is no CSRF token, which means that this could be a CSRF. So let's make this clear. Right now we just manual tested the app, and so some, you know, pretty much basic things, and we knew some XSS and SQL injection. Until now, ChatGPT didn't found the SQL injection that we found in the cookie, but we did. But right here, as you can see, ChatGPT giving you a bunch of ideas to try, and this is really fine. And actually, the most important thing that ChatGPT helps me with is when you want to create a specific script that you want to run for doing some specific thing based on the vulnerability you are working with. For example, when I get a vulnerability that I have to write code, for example, using jQuery or other programming languages or libraries that I don't have that knowledge of, I can just ask him to do it and he will do it pretty well and too much other things. So that's pretty much it for ChatGPT. And of course, you can just tell him this didn't work, this works, this didn't work, this works, and he will keep continue with you until you find your vulnerability. AI simply speeds up the process by generating, you know, basic payloads, and if you just ask him to generate more complex payloads, it will do it and just suggest some testing strategies and so on. So that's pretty much it. So can AI replace hackers? Not quite, but can it be a powerful assistant? Absolutely. Tools like ChatGPT can generate creative test cases and speed up discovery, but they still need a skilled human for validation and strategy. Have you tried using AI for bug bounty hunting? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And if you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below, or you can just reach me directly using Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.